Welcome to Electron Line, and now let's talk about the modern days of radio astronomy. The radio telescopes of the VLA are an absolute wonder of engineering. The VLA stands for Very Large Array, and this was built in central New Mexico. There's lots of open space in New Mexico, a lot of long, large valleys, and they found a location where they were able to build railroad tracks kind of in a upside-down Y shape, on which they put on railroad cars 27 radio telescopes like this. They just put them on railroad cars, and so they were able to just drive them around or scurry them around along those tracks. So what they would do when they want to do radio astronomy and get large resolution angle, or I should say small resolution angles, they would take these radio telescopes and equally space them out in those three directions. The length from this to the top portion, which is in the northern direction, was 21 kilometers long, and those two legs going in these directions right here, that would be the southwest and the southeast, are each 19 kilometers long, and they would equally space those 27 total dishes or arrays over those large distances to, in effect, have an equivalent telescope of a diameter of 27 kilometers. The reason why that is necessary is with radio telescopes, since the wavelengths are so large compared to visible light, that would cause a very large angle of resolution angle. They'll want to compensate for that with a very large diameter. And so 27 kilometer diameter compensates for that to the point where the angle of resolution is somewhere around 0.05 arc seconds, which is about 1/20th of an arc second, which is really, really good in modern telescope technology. So for radio telescopes to get that kind of resolution, it's absolutely amazing. It's as good as some of our best visual telescopes on Earth. Now, each of them had a diameter of 25 meters. Well, how does that compare to some of the very big radio telescopes that have a diameter of by as much as 100 meters? Imagine a soccer field put on a dish and pointed to the sky like that. That's an absolute wonder. But 25 meters, of course, is not as good as 100 meters, but if you have 27 of them, you kind of compensate for that. So let's see how much more energy can a 100 meter telescope collect versus a 25 telescope. Well, it all comes down to the area. So let's say that this is the area of a 25 meter telescope and A2 is the area of a 100 meter telescope. Remember that the area is equal to pi r squared when it comes to circles, and so this would be pi r squared for this one. If this one is 100 meters and this one is 25 meters in diameter, then this would be a 50 meter radius, this would be a 12 and a half meter radius. So the radius comparison would be 4 to 1. This is 4 times as big as this one in area. So if I square 4, for example, so 100 is 4 times 25, and if I then square 4, because we have to square 4 to get the area, then the area of this one, the area of the big one, is equal to 4 squared times the area of the small one, which is 16 times the area of the small one. So one of these big radio telescopes can receive as much energy as 16 of these. But if you have 27 of them, that's almost twice as much as this, so 27 of these dishes can receive almost twice as much energy as one of these giant radio telescopes. In addition to that, the angle of resolution of a 100 meter telescope is much, much larger and not as effective as the angle of resolution of a 27 diameter one. So this array can collect almost twice as much energy as one single giant radio telescope like this. In addition to that, it has a tremendous resolution angle, very, very tiny. You can see very, very good detail of the radio astronomy, the radio telescopes. So when we look out in space and we look for radio signals, we can really pinpoint the sources where they come from. And then we can take our visual telescopes, take pictures of those regions, put those together, and then know where exactly this radio astronomy or this radio energy is coming from. So this has been a tremendous advantage to radio astronomy. Not that these are not good, but in places, in countries where you don't have these wide open spaces, this is second best, of course. You can still get enormous amount of energy received. You just don't get the resolution angle that you would like and that you would get from a big array like that. But radio telescope from the early days has come a tremendous way, and with this now we have resolution angles almost as good as visual telescopes, and it's a tremendous advantage again to radio astronomy and astronomy in general to pinpoint those sources of radio energy coming from all the various places in the universe. And that's how we do that.